Today we're going to talk about the Bltouch on the Smart RAMPS board. In order to do that, I have to explain a couple of things real quick. We have our servo pins here. There are three sets in a row of four. And in that row, we have our digital pins. We have digital pin 11, 6, 5, and 4 for digital pins. Then we have our 5-volt rail, and then we have our ground rail. Now, in order to power the 5-volt rail, we need to jump the VCC pin to the 5-volt pin, and that is our ground pin, just so you know. So in order to do that, we take a jumper, and we put it on these two pins, and that allows current to flow from the VCC to the 5-volt pin to power our rail. Now, the next thing we need to know is our end stops. Now, we have a row of six with three sets of pins in each row. The top row is our signal pins. The middle row is our ground. And the bottom row is our voltage. And the pin order is, the first row over here is X-min. Then we have X-max. Then we have Y-min. Then we have Y-max. Then we have Z-min, and then we have Z-max. So in order to do this, we need to connect on the bottom side of the Bltouch, the connector. Now it's notched, so the notches are on the bottom, so you slide it in. Apply a little bit of pressure to get it all the way down. And then the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to connect our wires. So the first set of wires, we have our yellow, red, or orange, and then we have brown. So the yellow wire is our signal pin, or wire. Our red is the 5 volts, and the black is the ground. So in order to connect this, we have to connect to digital pin 11, which is over here. Our signal pin's over where my finger is for my index finger. Can apply a little pressure to put that in place. Now for the Z-min, we have to connect these two pins here. So the center is going to be the black, and the white wire is going to be the signal. And then in order to load it, we have to connect the computer to the Smart RAMPS board. So we're going to connect the big side of the USB serial to the board. In order to do that, we have to use the right cable, of course. So I'm going to slide this into the programming port down below, which I've talked about in previous videos. And the other end goes into the computer, and you're going to hear a beep. And in a moment, I'll show you how we're going to load the Marlin firmware. Okay, the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to open up marlin-bugfix-2.0.x. This is an experimental version of Marlin because it hasn't been released yet, but you can still download it. We're going to go into the Marlin subfolder, and then we're going to go into the source folder. Inside the source folder, we're going to go to the core folder, and we're going to open up boards.h. Inside here, we're going to do a search on smart. And what we have is a bunch of different choices for the smart RAMPS. But we're going to go with board_ramps_smart_EFB for extruder fan bed, and we're going to copy that. Then we're going to close out of here. We're going to go up a directory, then another directory, then we're going to go to the marlin.ino and open that up. Now we're going to go to the configuration.h tab. We're going to do a search on motherboard, and we're going to replace board_ramps_14_EFB with
board underscore ramps underscore smart underscore EFB. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to do a search on Bltouch. And as you can see, it's commented out, so we're going to remove the comments by backspacing them out. And then we're going to scroll down a little bit so I can show you some stuff. You can add a delay if you so choose, but for this example, I'm going to leave it out just so that it's quicker. So the next thing that we want to look for is number of servos, which will be num underscore servo. So num underscore servo. And as you can see, it's also commented out. So we're going to remove the comment. Now we have three servos that it's saying that we need to use. Now if you look down here, there's only one specified. Technically we're only using one, but if we had multiple, we'd do comma 300 for three servos. And if it were four, then we'd added an additional comma 300. But we're going to leave it the way it is for now. And all we're going to do is compile and upload. So we have to go over to Tools, and we have to find our board, which is the Arduino Due. And we're using the programming port. Next thing we need to do is make sure that we have a port specified, which we now do. So we're going to click the Upload button, which will compile and then upload to the Smart Ramps board. So in a moment, I'll show you in Pronterface how we're going to test it. Okay, we're going to, in the Pronterface folder now, we're going to open up Pronterface. We're going to connect to the Smart Ramps board. We're then going to press Home for Z in a moment, but before we do that, we're going to check the status of the end stops by typing M119 and pressing enter. And as you can see, the Z min is open, whereas the X and Y min are triggered. That is because they're not connected. So what we're going to do is we're going to press the Z button, and then I'm going to show you with my hand how to actuate it, to test it. So here we go. Okay, now to check it, to make sure that it's actuated, we're going to press M119 again and see what the status is. And it says triggered. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.